Tonight, on a special Dateline. She's gone from the top of the charts to the talk of the tabloids. Now Britney Spears says she's had enough, and tonight, she fires back.
I think 90% of the world would agree that the tabloids have kind of gone a little far with me lately.
In her first primetime interview since her wedding and her baby, she says she wants to set the record straight, shooting down those rumors about her marriage.
When the magazine screams on the cover, pregnant and divorcing.
No, none of that's true.
She says she's a good mother.
You could possibly never realize you could love something that much.
But what about those so-called mommy mistakes? The baby on her lap.
I did it with my dad. I'd sit in his lap and I'd drive. We're country.
The baby in the car seat.
It was fine. They're just taking, again, cheap shots.
And the stumble with the baby.
It was a close call.
Accidents happen.
It's a Britney Spears you haven't seen before. Defiant.
As a mother, I have to speak.
Determined.
I do not care what people think.
And emotional.
You have to realize that we're people.
A Dateline exclusive, Britney Spears speaking out after these brief messages. Good evening. This is how we knew her best, from sexy videos of big hit songs. A pop princess who at one time proclaimed she was not that innocent. Lately, though, you're more likely to see Britney Spears like this, in less than flattering pictures with tabloids and magazines raising all kinds of sarcastic questions about her appearance, her marriage, even how she cares for her son. In her quick trip from famous to infamous, the one-time golden girl now finds herself accused of everything, from being a homewrecker to, even more painful, a bad mom. Up to now, Britney hasn't had much to say, but tonight, in a candid and emotional interview, she answers back. If once she was not that innocent, she now says, back off. She's not perfect, but she's not that guilty either.
I'm very, very blessed. But my safety and my privacy and respect are three things that I feel like are trying to be taken away from me right now. As a mother, I have to speak and I have to say something. Why don't you do
something? The song is called Do Something, and that's just what a defiant Britney Spears is setting out to do tonight, taking on the tabloids. Because after a year of screaming headlines scrutinizing her husband, their marriage, and most stinging of all, her abilities as a mother, she's not just dealing with some bad press, but an image implosion.
Oftentimes in my end of the business, we have to beg people to do interviews. And yet it seems as if you're anxious to talk at this particular stage in your life. You've got some things you'd like to address.
I think because I was pregnant, I didn't, you know, with my son, I didn't want to do interviews and all that kind of thing. You know what I mean? I tried to want it to be a little bit private, but I think 90% of the world would agree that the tabloids have kind of gone a little far with me lately, and I think it's time, you know, I do need to speak up a little bit, you know. You try not to respond to trash, because that's what it is, but, you know, when they've, I think they've crossed the line a little bit.
So Britney is drawing her own line in the sand, taking on what she sees as an overly intrusive and downright dangerous tabloid press. It's just one of many things we discuss in a refreshingly honest, no-holds-barred interview. A pregnant Britney invited us to her California home to talk about it all. Her career, her past loves, the state of her marriage, and those now infamous mommy mistakes.
You know, you've got this incredible place that you call home and then you and Kevin have built together. Is it a sanctuary, or at times does it feel a little like a prison?
No, it's a sanctuary. Totally. My dad comes here and he's like, oh my gosh, I feel like I'm at a resort. It's awesome here. What? I love it.
Although she seems to still be a sweet southern girl dressed down in casual clothes, chewing gum firmly planted in her mouth, okay. It may surprise you that Britney Spears has become one tough cookie.
I don't allow anybody to change me. I still walk out of my house in rollers. And I take walks. I do not care what people think. And I think that's the thing why they keep on talking is because they know they can't touch
me. So you have a little bit of a blank you attitude about it now.
Yeah, basically. I mean, you have to. I mean, I have to live my life. I have a family now. And I just think it's absurd, you know, to let other people influence the way you live.
Britney is, of course, no stranger to being under the media microscope. The 24-year-old has been in front of the cameras more than half of her young life. We first got to know her as a preteen mouseketeer, along with future boyfriend Justin Timberlake and fellow singing sensation Christina Aguilera on the new Mickey Mouse Club. And then, just 6 years later, she hit the big time. Clad in that now famous schoolgirl uniform, a then 17-year-old Britney Spears became a sensation with Baby One More Time, her first number one hit. She was not just a pop star, but a phenomenon, selling millions of records and attracting worldwide media attention. But she says the scrutiny she's living with now is a completely different ballgame.
It's not just like how it used to be where they would just like take your picture, give you respect, and then you'd walk by. It's like a scary, they just come out of nowhere. And it's kind of, you know, you're like, oh my gosh, you know. And
without giving anything away, you live in a house that's surrounded by a fence. You have a gate. Mm-hmm. You've got security, not a person. Mm-hmm. You've got a detail of people who are here all the time. Without that, you would feel vulnerable here.
Oh, yeah, definitely. And I still have helicopters that come twice a day.
Just trying to get a picture of you with the pool or you with
Just anything.
Sean?
Yeah, and they put the captions on their magazines, baby in danger and stuff like that, which is really silly, but I wouldn't be in danger if I didn't have, like, this, you know, this impactful thing around me all the time. And I just feel like the editors, they don't realize that there's not just one magazine. There's other magazines, and they're all paying to get a story. And I think that the energy from the people is getting, it's kind of scary. Like, I can't really leave my home right now.
And also scary, in a world built on image, is how all those headlines, that Britney has a lousy marriage, that her husband plays around, that she's a bad mother, no matter how untrue, are affecting just how the public sees Britney Spears. I'm not that innocent. Not that she hasn't been down the bumpy road of damage control before, as she transformed herself from the idol of little girls everywhere to a sexier version the boys could like as well, people began to question whether she was an appropriate role model for their kids. And she only added to the controversy by vowing to remain a virgin until marriage, a pledge that was questioned every time a new sexy video was released.
How you feel about all the constant speculation about your virginity and whether you are a virgin or not?
I really wish I would have never said anything to begin with.
Let me ask you if there was a turning point. It seemed for a while you lived a charmed life. You were that blonde little girl that everyone loved, the squeaky clean image, even if every once in a while you kind of sexed it up a little bit and caught people by surprise. And everybody said great things about you. They wanted you to be a role model for their daughter. And then all of a sudden it seemed that the press turned. And they decided that maybe you were someone they wanted to take some shots at.
They like to pick, have the person they pick on. I feel like I'm a target, and I feel like other girls are, at a certain point in everyone's career, they'll get it.
But when did it happen in your career? Can you look back? Was there an event? Was there something, you know, that you did, you think, that brought it
Usually
on?
Usually breakups and personal lives, it starts to happen. Look at Jessica Simpson, for instance. They're being so rude to her right now. It's her split up with Nick. It's like this whole thing.
She did great. She did great.
Thanks, baby.
Love you.
Britney says her own breakup with first love Justin Timberlake 4 years ago was the beginning of the end of not only their love affair, but the press's love affair with her.
Tell me you love me. Why did you leave me?
By the time a wounded Justin alluded to a betrayal by Britney in his song Cry Me a River, it was clear Britney Spears was no longer America's sweetheart.
Do you think perhaps the breakup with Justin, was that when you started to sense the tide turning a little bit in your life? There were allegations about infidelity. Did that put the spotlight on you in a negative sense?
I do think there was a little shift there, definitely.
And then she gave the tabloids a present wrapped in a big bow, a quickie Vegas wedding to her childhood friend Jason Alexander in January 2004. Almost as quick, the annulment that followed.
Oh, that was just silly.
But do you think that gave the press something to talk about?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Another negative aspect.
Yeah, yeah.
She says she now understands that the marriage was an act of rebellion on her part.
I was on the road for a while, and again, I was doing a lot of what I was told instead of what I wanted to really do, and I didn't know how to break out of that. So in my young mind, I'm like, I'm going to just get married to someone of my home friends. You know what I mean? It was just like something, but I have no regrets with anything that I've ever done.
And that includes her relationship with her present husband, Kevin Federline, father of their 9-month-old son, Sean Preston. When Brittany met Kevin in a Los Angeles club 2 years ago, he was a backup dancer and already a young dad, having fathered a child with actress Shar Jackson and another baby on the way.
You know, so much was written and said about the way the relationship began between you and Kevin, not so much about the way it began, but the timing of it beginning, that he left his girlfriend when she was pregnant. Mm-hmm. I think 6 months pregnant, Shar was. Did that bother you? Did you stop and think, wait a second, that's a very delicate situation?
Actually, I didn't know. I didn't know until 2 months later. But I don't blame him, because him and his friends, I've talked to his friends about this, they weren't technically together when he came to me anyways. They were, you know, apart. But that happened with Julia Roberts too, but it's more talked about and more of an issue with me. Like, her husband was married and had kids when they first got together. But for some reason, it's like, boom, in your face when it happens with me. And it's really none of anybody's business.
Brittany is referring to Julia Roberts' relationship with husband Danny Motor, who was married when they met, but did not have any children.
You said to me a couple of times already today you believe in karma.
Mm-hmm.
And as someone who is now several months pregnant, do you ever stop and think, you know, he left someone else when she was a couple of months pregnant? Does that ever cross your mind?
No, because we're very happy together right now.
Not if you believe the tabloids, which claim that Brittany and Kevin are breaking up, that he's dating others and living in the basement at home. When we return, Brittany sets the record straight.
So he's living here?
Oh, definitely.
Living on the ground, the main floor?
Yes, of course.
There's not a basement somewhere?
He helps me. He has to. I'm an emotional wreck right now.
When Britney Spears speaking out continues.
So when the magazine screams on the cover, pregnant and divorcing, you want people to know?
No, none of that's true.
In her song Toxic, Britney Spears talks about a poisonous relationship. But despite what the tabloids say, she says that's not what her life is like with husband Kevin Federline.
Let's talk about married life.
Okay.
All right. How's your marriage?
Awesome, thank you.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Britney Spears and Kevin Federline will celebrate their second anniversary in September. They have a 9-month-old son, Sean Preston, and another baby on the way, which Britney chose to publicly announce on The Late Show with David Letterman.
Don't worry, Dave, it's not yours.
Well, I think that's good news for both of us. Well, we've established now that you are, in fact, pregnant. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Oh, well, there you go. See, Paul?
A televised birth announcement. No surprise there, considering Mr. and Mrs. Federline have been living in front of the cameras ever since they started their relationship. And don't just blame the paparazzi. Although Britney claims she wants her privacy, she had no problem turning her relationship with Kevin into a reality show, Britney and Kevin Chaotic, which aired on UPN.
Let's get crazy!
It's a good balance. It's like we're friends and we have good sex.
And with the Federlines feeding the very hand that bites them, it's no surprise that the marriage of a multi-millionaire pop star and a former backup dancer and aspiring rapper who left his pregnant girlfriend to be with said pop star has raised the tabloids' interest in Britney to a level she couldn't have imagined back in those Mouseketeer days.
Let me show you some magazines, okay?
Okay.
These are all current, all right? I don't have to show you them all, but we got one here. Britney Moves On Without Kevin. Brit's New Man.
Oh, no. That's my security guard.
The Final Days, fed up with Kevin's lies, he's sleeping in the basement. We'll get to these individually, but basically this is the tone, that this marriage is over, there are problems in paradise, and it's not going to last.
You know what? I need to create my own magazine. These people, like, they want stories to sell, and they're very good, you know? I need to come up with my own magazine and... say the real deal.
We'll set the record straight. I mean, first of all, can I, in an effort of full disclosure, when I came through the gate today, the first person I saw was Kevin.
Yeah.
So he's living here.
Oh, definitely. And he's working very hard.
Living on the ground, the main floor?
Yes, of course.
He's not, there's not a basement somewhere?
He helps me. He has to. I'm an emotional wreck right now.
Are you really?
Not in a bad way, just the whole, just, you know, I'll start laughing hysterically and then I'll just start crying. Like, just because.
So it's the hormones of the pregnancy racing through your body.
Yeah, so it's nice to have my husband there to keep me company.
Do you get the sense, Brittany, that people are rooting against this marriage? And I don't mean just the magazine editors. I mean people.
I don't really know. I don't know. If they are, then I think that's sad. I think everybody should be pro-love, you know? And I know it sounds so silly, but I feel like love conquers all. I know that sounds like, but it does.
One of the magazines asked the question on the cover. It said, can this marriage be saved? And then they went on and answered their own question and said, we hope not.
Aww. What magazine was that?
It's here somewhere, I think. Can she work it out with Kevin? We hope not.
Like I said, I try not to respond to trash.
What do you see in him? What is it about Kevin that makes you love him?
It's very simple. Women complicate everything. He's so simple. His simplicity and just, he's like a boy. He just, you know, and he cares. He cares so much, and his heart is awesome. He has a really big heart, and I love that.
Kevin has been a tabloid target himself these past few months, called everything from a freeloader to a philanderer, which he strongly denies. Recently, he's tried to do a little image makeover of his own, posing for a cleaned-up cover shot for this month's Item magazine.
Hey, Brittany, beautiful couple.
The 28-year-old didn't want to be interviewed the day we visited, but he recently spoke with Access Hollywood and demoed his debut CD. In the interview, he raved about Brittany.
She's so supportive. From the first time I went in and started recording about beginning of the summertime, she was there, you know. She was pregnant and everything, boy. She was right there.
And Kevin talked about how he's been misunderstood.
I have feelings and hurt and happy, sad, cry, fight, all that, everything. It's no different than nobody else.
And as for those tabloid taunts that he's a gold digger, Kevin maintains he's his own man.
I've been paying for everything out of my pocket. Everything.
And although Brittany is clearly the breadwinner in this family, she's well aware just how important it is for her husband to pull his own weight.
You know, he has children now that he, you know, with me, that he wants to support and not just let it be all me. You know, he's a man. And so I think it's very important to him that he is doing his own thing.
Do you think there's a sense out there, Brittany, that some people who love you and have watched you grow up, go through the pop princess years and into young adulthood, get some feeling that he's not good enough for you?
Oh, that would hurt me for anybody to say that. You know, that would be horrible for someone to say that, because I love him and that's all that matters.
So if there's a headline to come out of the marriage portion of this interview, it is that you're happy and there is no end in sight to this marriage.
No.
You look at me sometimes when I say things like that, almost like a little puppy dog, like it.
No, because I say it because I just feel for him, you know, because he's a man and he has to, you know, he's trying to work and do his thing and I feel bad for him.
Well, how does it affect him when he hears about this? When he hears everybody, you know, predicting that this marriage is over, that he's living in the basement, that he's on the way out.
I want to cry. That hurts me for him.
What hurts Brittany most is the accusation that she's not a good mother. Coming up, she explains why she was visited by authorities checking on the welfare of her baby and talks about those so-called mommy mistakes. But first, Brittany responds to something else that people are saying about her.
They started saying maybe she's a little bit of a redneck.
I think that's just cruel, but I just, you know, I feel like when you put labels on people like that and you do that, at the end of the day, they're just words.
When we return with Britney Spears speaking out.
Britney Spears has not even reached her 25th birthday, and she's already made her mark in the music world. Not only did her first album, Baby One More Time, hit number one, she followed that up not just one more time, but three, for a total of four consecutive albums debuting at number one. No other female artist has done that. Not even Madonna, who introduced Britney to Kabbalah and taught her that a kiss is not just a kiss, not if it's on MTV. More on their relationship later. I met Britney right after her first taste of success when she performed at the Christmas tree lighting in Rockefeller Center back in 1999.
This has been such an amazing year for you. Have you had time to stop and enjoy it?
Well, actually, things have been so crazy and things have been really, really fast. But just, I was home for like a week for Thanksgiving. I totally realized how blessed I've been this past year. It gave me a time just to really think about things. It's been really amazing.
Wow, good.
And although she's come a long way since that interview, now a very rich woman with a reported net worth of more than $100 million, Britney says she's still the same down-home girl from Kentwood, Louisiana.
It seemed for a while people would describe you, they'd say, she's this great young thing from the South, you know, small town girl.
I still am, man.
I know, but then all
I'm
of a sudden.
I'm in good tea, okay?
But then all of a sudden, they started to use that Southern background in a different way. The tone of it changed. All of a sudden.
They make you feel like you have to have your transformation.
Well,
Madonna, reinvent yourself, right?
Right, but yeah. They started saying, maybe she's a little bit of a redneck. You started to hear that it wasn't a good thing, that you, all of a sudden it wasn't a good thing, your roots. They started to try and make it a negative thing. How did you feel about that?
I think anybody who's doing well in the public eye or whatever, there's always going to be a shift because people don't want to see somebody happy all the time. And they're going to try to take shots at people. You know, they did the same thing to Goldie Hawn when she did her show. And before she did Private Benjamin and all that, and then all of a sudden she became like this, oh my God, she's a star, you know. But they still gave her flack for her past and her.
Does the term bother you when you hear redneck? Because it's not used in a Gretchen Wilson
proud
of. Well, it's not used that way. I think
that's just cruel. You know, I think that's cruelty when you judge people. And I'm not a Bible Belt, but I just, you know, I feel like when you put labels on people like that and you do that, at the end of the day, they're just words, and that's what I have to look at them. I mean, you have to be really strong, you know, and just be like, if that's what you want to say, then, you know, okay.
And this Louisiana girl now lives in luxury in California. Because of security concerns, she didn't want us to show her home. She did give us a tour of her lush backyard and admit, although she's not desperate, she's a housewife through and through.
I like to cook, try to cook. And I like to clean. I clean and I'm obsessive like that. And I like to, if I watch TV, I do watch The Home, redoing the house,
right.
Whole thing. And I get into like redoing my living room and the baby's room and all that
so
stuff.
So do you clean the house by yourself?
Yes, I have a maid that comes once a week, but she slacks a little bit. But,
I were to come here and ring the doorbell by surprise, I could
cleaning.
Catch you vacuuming. Doing the toilets?
Doing the laundry, everything. Mm-hmm.
See, there's a side of you we didn't know.
Oh, honey, that is the real me, honey.
I pictured there'd be housekeepers around here.
No, I mean, this house is so big, I have to have some help.
In early fall, Britney will have another room to clean, never mind diapers to change, when baby number two arrives.
How far along are you?
I am, I don't know. I think 6 to 7 months.
So you're due in September?
Mm-hmm.
September, do you know what you're having?
I do not know.
Are you going to find out?
No, I want to be surprised. I'm very excited.
Talk about motherhood.
Motherhood?
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Is it what you thought it would be?
It's more.
In what way?
I mean, you could possibly never realize you could love something that much.
Was that the way it was from the very beginning?
Oh, yeah. The moment, I saw him, just, it's amazing. I can't, words can't really describe.
Tell me about him, describe him a little bit for me. I love to hear mothers describe their children.
We'll make this interview about other stuff.
now. That's okay.
I love my son, and, you know, that's great. And I wanted to touch on some things with my husband because of the tabloids, but I try to keep my baby out of this whole thing.
But, of course, Britney has not been able to keep her baby out of the spotlight or the tabloids. When we return, Britney Spears explains those infamous pictures, the ones that triggered so much controversy. And you'll see the toll it's all taken on a young mother.
What do you think it'll take to get the paparazzi to leave you alone? Is that one of your biggest wishes?
Yeah. It's okay.
When Britney Spears speaking out continues. Oops, she did it again. Britney Spears gives her side of those so-called mommy mistakes and fires back at those who say she's not a good mother when Dateline continues. In 2001, Britney Spears sang that she was not a girl, not yet a woman. Well, now she's a wife and mother in full-on protective mode, coming out swinging against those who are slamming her skills as a parent. Tonight, for the first time, she's taking on her critics and explaining one by one each of those damning pictures which seem to show her child in danger. As our emotional interview continues, Britney goes after not just the paparazzi and the tabloids, but even the doctors who recently treated her son.
Yes, Britney Spears has achieved that Hollywood hat trick. Success, money, and fame. Yet she says her greatest accomplishment is being a mom.
Motherhood's amazing.
But the one thing that gives her so much joy is, ironically, the very same thing that's made these past few months a very difficult time for Britney Spears. In February, Britney was photographed driving on the Pacific Coast Highway with her baby in her lap, in the front seat. It was a picture that became not only a punchline.
But in her defense, the baby had to sit on her lap because her husband Kevin was asleep in the child seat. So apparently.
But the source of serious debate all across the country.
I think it's very important that Britney gets some baby safety training.
Oh, yeah.
Tonight, for the first time, Britney explains just what happened.
You were photographed, I guess, by the paparazzi again, pursuing you. Mm-hmm. And there was Sean on your lap in the car.
Yeah.
Take me through what happened there.
If right now we got in the car and went to Starbucks, you would see 20 photographers there. And I went to Starbucks and I see a bunch of photographers and I'm scared and I want to get out of the situation and my baby's crying. They're coming up on the, you know, the sides of the car, which is a scary situation for me, you know, and they're banging on the windows and that's not something I want my baby to, you know, so I get my baby out of the car and I go home. So, I mean, and I just feel like they're taking cheap shots.
But the fact of the matter is, while they pursue you, and we can argue for a long time, they shouldn't be doing it. And I would agree with you on that completely. Mm-hmm. They managed to snap a picture that didn't cast you in the best light.
Oh, of course. That is their job. Mm-hmm. And they do a very good job at it. And they've crossed the line so many times, you know. And I think because I'm a sweet young girl, nothing ever gets really done about it, you know.
When you were driving with Sean on your lap, did it clearly?
And it's seriously that driving incident. I did it with my dad. I'd sit in his lap and I'd drive. We're country. That's what, you know what I mean.
But what happened though? It crossed from a paparazzi incident to next day. It's in the newspapers, and you've got all these legitimate people weighing in, saying, you know what? That's dangerous, and she put her child at risk. You saw the questions that were being asked: Is Britney a bad mom?
Mm-hmm.
It's not like. Did Britney record a bad song?
Mm-hmm.
Is Britney wearing a bad outfit? Is Britney in a bad marriage?
Yeah.
Is Britney a bad mom?
Mm-hmm. That's America for you.
Yeah, but as a mother, that has to hit pretty close to home.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, makes you really strong.
Make you weep?
Oh, I've wept. Yeah. I've definitely wept just with the world, you know, how judgmental they are. You know what? I know I'm a good mom.
But just a few weeks after the baby in the lap incident, Britney's son, while in the care of a nanny, fell out of a high chair and banged his head.
You took him to the doctor?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, of course.
So you walked into the hospital and said he bumped his head, fell out of a high chair.
And then the doctors acted really funny with me. I know. It was really bizarre.
Well, how'd they act funny?
I don't want to say, but they did.
Suspicious?
Like I said, I don't want to say what they did or what they said. But it was bad. It was really, really bad.
Do you think, though, Brittany, that because of those questions that were asked after that picture on Pacific Coast Highway with Sean in your lap, that the doctor in that emergency room or that hospital said, wait a second, maybe I have a bad mom on my hands?
I was just happy that my son was okay, and I wanted to get home and get out of there.
And then not long after that, you got a visit from the family services people.
Yeah, in which actually they felt really bad about it. They said, we don't even know why we're here.
So in other words, they came because it's their job to come. They have to investigate.
They didn't have to come. The doctor there made them come because I didn't bring my doctor there with me. So people a lot of times think because you're a celebrity that you're taken care of more. In some situations, people, you're not, you get it worse.
And it didn't end there. In May, Spears was photographed driving her baby in a front-facing car seat. Not illegal, but against federal safety guidelines.
Oh, it was right. Fine. They're just taking, again, cheap shots. Yeah.
And just days after that photo appeared, on a visit to New York City, Brittany stumbled again, this time literally.
You're walking with Sean in one arm, and you tripped on, what was it, your pants?
I think, actually, I didn't trip on anything. It was New York street. Just cobblestones, and I was walking, and I only was prepared with one security because I've never had that much paparazzi ever on me in New York, so we didn't even know there was going to be that many people. So I think it was a mixture of so many paparazzi and just how the road was all messed up, me just trying to get in the car.
It was a close call. I mean, it seemed as if for a second, you know.
Accidents happen.
Right.
And when he gets my brother, when he was like 13 years old, he got in like 4 motorcycle accidents, had to be airlifted, you know. Stuff happens with kids. It's reality, you know. Unfortunately, not everybody has 80 cameras on them 24/7, you know.
And there was a picture taken shortly afterward, and you appeared to be crying.
Oh, yeah.
Very upset. Were you upset because you just had a close call with your son, or were you upset because the lenses were still on you?
Well, because I got in the car, and I was hungry, and we stopped to get something to eat, and it was, again, a bad situation. And instead of the people inside of the place, like, being, like, you know, trying to help or whatever, they wanted to take pictures as well. And that's when I started crying, when I thought, you know what, you're a mom. Why are you asking to take my picture right now? And you see that I'm crying. Are you that ignorant? So that's why I cried.
And the headline on that picture was Oops Number 3.
Exactly. There'll be an Oops 100. There'll be plenty more Oopses. I'm not perfect. I'm human.
What do you think it'll take to get the paparazzi to leave you alone?
I don't know. I don't know.
Is that one of your biggest wishes?
Yeah. It's okay. I would like for them to leave me alone.
If you could talk to them as individuals, not as a group, what would you say to them?
I would just say that you have babies at home, and you have a life, and if you don't, you have to realize that we're people, and that we just need privacy, and we need our respect, and those are things that you have to have as a human.
And yet, as upset as it makes you, you wouldn't trade your life now, it seems.
That seems
strange for some people to understand. If they're making you this miserable, how can you still say, but I'm lucky?
Because I have to believe that I'm here for a reason.
What's the reason?
I don't know. I keep searching every day, just like you do. But I'm so blessed with my baby. That's the happiest thing that's ever, it's like a miracle, you know. But I just want the most normal life possible for him. That's all.
Is that possible?
I will manage. I will create that.
Higher fences, bigger gates. I mean, how are you going to do that, Brittany?
There's always a way. Where there's a will, there is a way. You have to believe.
So what's next for Britney? Her dreams for the future, personally and professionally, now that she's not that innocent.
The reason why maybe this is happening is I won't take BS from anyone.
When we return with Britney Spears speaking out. The song is called Someday. At the time, Britney was about to become a mother and was singing to her unborn baby boy. You see it all in your baby. She says the birth of Sean Preston has changed her not only personally, but professionally.
It's hard for me to work right now. I tried to do a photo shoot the other day, and my son was not even letting me leave, you know. Like, we're very attached.
Yes, Britney Spears sounds like any conflicted working mom. It helps explain why My Prerogative was one of the last new singles she released, and that was back in 2004. And sorry, Britney fans, it looks like she has no plans to go back into the recording studio anytime soon.
I'm thinking about waiting like a year or two to come out with music again. We'll see. It's just, I feel like I want my boo-boos to be a little bit older, because when I do music, I want to do it for real, and I want to travel, and I just want to make sure they're old enough to be able to be on that kind of pace with me.
What kind of music would you be thinking about? Because you're at that kind of...
I have no idea.
Well, but it's an interesting time in a career for someone like you, because you're not 17 anymore.
Right.
You know, you're going to be, what, 25?
Mm-hmm.
And so what kind of music is going around in your head these days?
I think the key to good music is it's got to be timeless. You've got to work with the best people, and you have to just, you know, and finding, experimenting in the studio and finding your knack.
But because you're a businesswoman, you know when you release new music, there is an audience out there. And who is that audience now for Britney Spears?
I don't know.
But it doesn't mean she isn't keeping busy. She found time to do a guest appearance on NBC's Will and Grace.
Hi, I'm Amber Louise from the great state of Alabama.
Oh, even better, a British woman.
Was it fun for you?
It was awesome.
Why? What was so great about it?
Because I hadn't, you know, been out there and for so long, so it was really exciting for me. And I just love funny people. Funny people are great, you know, and so hilarious. You know, that was awesome.
Do you have someone out there today that you pattern yourself after that you would like to duplicate in terms of a career?
I love Goldie Hawn. I think she is so brilliant. I think she's like a free spirit. I also, as far as music goes, I love Shania Twain because her music is timeless. I love Pink. I think she's a great entertainer, and she's always making statements, which stands out. She has something to say. She's a very smart girl.
There was a time where something was made of the fact that you kind of looked up to Madonna. Do you still have a relationship with her?
No. I respect her work, and I think she's a very smart lady. She introduced me to Kabbalah.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that was at a time in my life where I was kind of searching for something. I needed something to really believe in. And I do believe that Kabbalah has codes to the world and all that. But I don't live by it like those people do.
I think I read somewhere where you said, right now, my baby is my religion.
Yeah.
And being a mom has inspired Britney Spears' businesswoman to launch a new venture.
I have a baby clothesline that's supposed to be coming out. And it's called Baby Soul Rock and Roll. And
you're designing all the...
Designing everything. There's two separate categories. There's the more elite line, and there's the rock and roll part, too. But it's the cutest stuff you've ever seen in your life.
You like business, don't you?
Mm-hmm, yeah. I like money.
Britney Spears has certainly come a long way from the teenager on the verge of superstardom I interviewed 7 years ago.
Actually, this coat is really, really warm, so it is kind of cold.
Yeah, you're going to have to start moving around to really get the juices flowing.
When you move around, it really does help.
That was long before she knew just how famous she would become and the price she'd have to pay.
If I had said to you when you were 17 and we were doing some interview in Rockefeller Center, I said, Britney, here's what it's going to be like when you're 24 or 25. Do you think you would have had second thoughts about pursuing this career?
No, I have no regrets. I love where I'm at right now, and actually I find everything happens for a reason, and the reason why maybe this is happening is I won't take BS from anyone, and I think it's making me stand out on my own and be very independent and fight for what I believe in, whereas before I was a young blonde girl who would do what she was told.
and I know who I am as a person, and I'm getting damn strong.
So, what do you think? When it comes to Britney Spears, have the paparazzi gone too far? We want you to tell us by voting on our website. The address is dateline.msnbc.com. And that's all for this special edition of Dateline. For Stone Phillips, Ann Curry, and all of us at NBC News, thanks for watching and have a good night.
Now, stay tuned for the new hit drama critics call Engaging. On the Money, summer's must-see drama. Windfall begins now on NBC.